Hey, good morning again. So this is our agenda for today. As you can see here, we have six topics this morning. So first, we have an overview of earthing introduction. And then we are going to move to soil resistivity test. The third one is on design, the manual calculation. Here we have good activities. I will divide you into groups and we'll do some design calculation. The fourth one is on installation and earth test, where you understand some common practices, some common problems, and you also get hands-on on the exothermic welding. And fifth is a CDEX simulation. So I think this one, only a handful of people know about this CDEX simulation. I will demonstrate to you later on. And then finally, we have our closing and go back. Right? So estimate 4 hours, we will finish this within 4 hours. Now, before we start anything, so we need you to have some ice breaking because I think some of you don't know each other, right? So please introduce yourself by stating your name, your company, and also your position. Right? I think starting with the new company.
The earthing
is there to protect you. The Erling normally represented by the green table, the green, yellow table. So later we're going to see more of that. And in the building, so if we have a lightning protection, so when lightning strikes, then we will strike this, okay, and then also to be channeled down to this Erling. So the concept is you have a low resistance path, then the electricity will not strike up all other places. They will go through this and then come down to earth. Okay? So it's for your safety. Now imagine a system without earning. So again, you have your live and neutral wire, and then if there is a fault happen, let's say a short circuit, then where will this fault go? They will go to any place of, including the people, if let's say you are touching the equipment. Then here also, you can see here, if lightning strike, you have your earning. Earning can also go up from the earning cable to our equipment. So there is this statement. So this is statement that if I say I remove the earning, then I will have less surge. I will have less lightning surge because now I eliminate this path for the earning. If you know about the soil resistivity, every meter is about maybe 100 ohm to 300 ohm. 100 to 300, that is the typical soil value. But if let's say you have your copper tape or copper wire over here, the resistance is very, very little. It's like 0.0001 something. So electricity will try to flow from the soil into this. So if let's say okay, you are the contractor, then you say, I remove this earth cable, can or not? You will reduce lightning surge. But when something happens, you do not have this safe path to divert this fault down to earth. So it's a matter of choice if you want to protect equipment or you want to protect your life. And by law in Malaysia, you must have earthing. Okay, so we have no choice, you must have earthing. Then the sales can sell more such protector. Understand? So who knows the body resistance of a human being? Typical body resistance of a human being. We start with the first question. We have a winner! No, okay, the answer is 1,000 ohm. 1,000 ohm, right? Okay, back to this. Okay, here are some of the examples of fault. Insulation failure, okay, very common. Lightning surge, also very common. When there's a lightning, then there's a surge. The case drops. So these are some of the examples of the fault that might happen in the system. Okay, here is a bit technical already. How many of you are not from electrical background? Wow! Okay. Explain one by one. Okay, this is a three-phase system. So in a big office like this, it's definitely three-phase. My house is only single-phase because it's less power. But a three-phase system, okay, where this is a red line. This one, red, yellow, blue, three-phase. Then each phase, phase-to-phase is 415 volt. This is why we have our SPD 415, DGT 40 something, right? So this is phase to phase. This is neutral. So phase to neutral, the potential difference is 240 volt. This is the voltage. Okay. And this is earth. So earth, okay, once you have this short between phase and earth, short circuit over here. So it becomes becomes 415. So it becomes a 4, then the 4 current equals to 240, because the formula V equals to IR. 240 volt divided by the resistance of cable, the resistance of earth rod, the resistance of ground, and the resistance of this rod. So this is the part. This will be the 4. And this is a phase to earth rod, because phase to earth is shorter. Now, another common one is phase to neutral 4. Again, same thing, red, yellow, blue. So phase to neutral is 240. Then phase to phase is 415. This is the normal condition. If you have a short between the phase and neutral one short here, then here becomes 0, right? Then your phase, the 4 current becomes 240, because 120 plus 120 divided by this resistance of cable. So this part is your 4. Okay, this part is your 4. And then after you short, the potential difference between a phase and neutral becomes 307 volts. Now, if you have a SPD, this is something advanced. You have an SPD, the UC, the activation voltage for the surge protector is 320. So it will not trigger the SPD. Because 317 only, it will not trigger. But if let's say your SPD, the UC is 280 volts, so it already triggered the SPD. So it will go into operation mode. Okay, that's an explanation. Now, these are all symmetrical for us, meaning we put it in an ideal solution. So my question to you all is this: do we die from this form? Do we die from this form? Go back to the wheel.
How long is the fault? That is why in every building you must have circuit breaker. taken. When there is a shot, when there's a fall happen, it should trip. Then you cut off. So the answer to Lola just now, if the building circuit breaker is not working, I think most likely to die. Okay. So that is why the circuit breaker RCD comes to practice. So later we'll look at the more example of the circuit breaker, but now we want to see the difference of the earthing and grounding.
Is fault current is because of design, it's always changed, or it's because of certain incident or internal situation just happened in short instant?
Most of the time, I will say it's installation.
The design, it's there, it's always there. Some noise or some incident.
In the real case, I don't think it's design. Because in Malaysia, the consultant always over-design. They have a very huge design always. So most of the time it's happened because of the wrong financial method. Or sometimes maybe the contractor is giving bad materials. For example, when they install, okay, they injured the cable jacket. Then there is an insulation. Let's say there's a line surge. It always happens that there's a line surge. Now if the cable is okay, then okay. But now one of your insulation is broken already. So they easily short because of the spike in the voltage, right? And then the circuit breaker trip. So when circuit breaker trip is a good thing in this sense because they will cut off the power. If not, they will go into your equipment, or when you're touching the equipment, then something might happen. So when we talk about earthing in Malaysia, then some of the, especially US countries, they will talk about grounding. So when people ask me what is the difference between earthing and grounding, I would say it's the same. Okay. But because in Malaysia, the earthing and grounding, they are the same. But if you go to US, or certain projects that are US-based, let's say Microsoft, data center, they may use a different system. So there is a difference between the earthing and grounding. Okay, the first thing, so earthing design, we are based more on the British standard or IEC standard. Okay, that's why it's more towards Europe and all the other countries. But in grounding, they refer to the UL, Underwriters Laboratory, and the IEEE standard. So this is a US-based standard. And the concept of earthing, okay, the neutral of the supply system is always connected to the, remember just now we have the live and neutral cable, so the neutral is always connected to ground. And then we call you have zero potential. So when we say this is a common system, meaning okay, the neutral is a common to all the three red, yellow, and green. Red, yellow, blue. So neutral is a common. And for this one, the grounding may be used to refer to the connection to a reference point that has zero potential with respect other points in the circuit. So whatever that reference point, it may not be neutral. Okay, there's a good example for solar. Because for certain solar projects, they do not have neutral. So in that case, your PE, your protective earth, your earth will be the reference point. So that will be the common mode. Then here, okay, the seals will be very familiar with this. We have the neutral earth and the frame earth. So frame earth, also known as the body earth. So when you have an equipment, and then they say, okay, I need a neutral earth for this. So the neutral earth will be for the system. The frame earth or the body earth will be for the body. So it is to protect people when, let's say, they're touching the frame, but touching the body. So you earth it, then because our body also has 1,000 ohms, then generally the electricity or the fault will choose off. So this is 1,000 ohms, and the body also have another earth, which is very low resistance, so most of the fault go through the earth. That's how it planned. And grounding, they have a few more. Wow, it's much complicated. The what solidity grounding system, high resistance grounding, low resistance grounding, vacuum grounding, resonance grounding. We never count these up. It's not my details. No here. Let's see. Okay, solidly grounded system is used in industrial commercial. High resistance are used in small and medium industry. The low resistance grounding are done by connecting value. Okay, reactants. Now we don't use it here. Okay,
safety. To put it very simple, the European standard will focus more on the safety of the human being. US standard, they focus more on the safety of equipment. So one is to focus more on protecting human, one is protecting the property, protecting the equipment. So that's the US. So there's a difference. And working, okay, they are achieved through connection of a of a metallic system to the earthing. So in many cases, they use copper. And then grounding, they ensure an alternative safe pathway for the current to flow back to the ground in case of fall. So they may not have a dedicated path for the earthing, for the grounding to work.
In America, in Asia, all is by earthing. It's not grounding. That's mostly on the ES, not grounding.
I would say for US system, they will have various systems.
Me for make sure they apply on burning only, no grounding. Except for solar, they need to have
something.
Or rare cases for solar.
There are some rare cases also. I give you an example. Our LRT. Our LRT on the rail system. MRT. MRT, we use third rail system. So third rail system means there's one plus and plus, plus and minus positive. And then the third one, they only have plus, they do not have the negative. So I consider this one as a grounding because they do not have a dedicated path for the current to go back to the source. So that would be more grounding.
Means the common is the earning.
But we call it earning over here. And then actually this one is unlikely you see this as grounding. Because in the following slides, I think we can go to the slide first. Okay. So we mostly have TT system, TNS system. TNC, TNCS is not allowed in Malaysia. It's stated very clearly in Malaysia standard. So let's see, we'll encounter all this. Okay, then in the market law, we often see this LVMESESE. Who can give me the full name for this? This is not standard, this is from our usage. Project, they have a mini earth and they also have a clean earth.
But for us, the main earth is actually the industrial earth, also called as service earth. Okay. Then in the normal design, when we design for consultant, then we call it the service earth. Is for the HT, high voltage or high tension. Then the electrical earth is the LV. Okay. Then the electrical earth something like that. So different.
Same.
It's just a norm, it's not a standard. So there's no fixed definition. But when we say main earth, electrical earth, then we roughly know what is going on. So there's also a clean earth. Clean earth usually who requests this data center. Data center, hospital. Okay. Why they want clean earth is they say okay they are afraid of interference, noise from other systems affect them. Or they also scared search will affect their equipment. So they say I want clean earth. Okay. But in terms of lighting protection, there is no such thing. You cannot find it in any standard, so there's no such thing as a clean earth. But normally, when people ask us to design clean earth, we also design
because what happens is the equipment supplier they will say that if you do not give me clean earth, I will not warranty the system.
So how? No choice. We have to design a clean earth for them. But normally at the ground level, they are still connected. They are still connected. Okay, I won't go into too much details, but let's say you have this requirement for clean earth, look for any engineers. What is earning?
I think we have done this. Self-directed.
Okay, so far, any questions on earning? Now we go to the different types of earning system. The first one, very common, is the TG system. Okay, there I go slowly. Once you get a hang of it, you can go faster. So again, this is the live cable, RYB, red, yellow, blue, three phase. And this is the neutral, called I1, I2, I3, so same. A very typical example is your house. So this one is your TMB. This one is your house or say your office. TMB have their own earth, this is a source. And here our house or this office also have our own earth. So it's called TD system because it looks like T. Okay? Okay, go on. The source of energy, one. Then the consumer installation, this one. Source earth. Where is three? Oh, three. Okay, source earth. This is the source. Equipment in installation, the form. Oh, okay. Sorry, what I said. So this is the source. This is equipment. This is equipment. Exposed conductive part here. Installation of the network. So both of this has the neutral is connected to earth. So if this is, we are using TNS system.
there is a grounding, but you're using the source grounding.
Yeah, exactly.
But why is E and S?
Separated.
The first one looks E. This one doesn't see any S,
but separated.
Separate.
I don't know why you call separate. It's our report.
So.
Okay, the neutral and protective conductor should be kept separate throughout the system. Oh, I forgot to mention. Okay, what is the benefit of TD system? The benefit of TD system is safer. That's why we use it in Malaysia, it's safer. Then the disadvantage is more expensive because you have to have earning at both ends. So TNS system, of course you can see is cheaper, but they have a disadvantage. If the protective conductor becomes open circuit, there's no indication of fault, meaning your circuit breaker won't trip. So that's a disadvantage. So it's less safer. Okay, we don't need to go into details, just general knowledge. TNC, definitely we don't use it here. TNC, your neutral and PE protective earth, they're using the same cable. And then of course here you can have earning also. Then what is the disadvantage, or they call it multiple earth connection. Multiple earth connection. And there is a risk of unbalanced load. So this is a disadvantage of the electrical system. And TNCS, also we won't see it here in Malaysia, because it's not allowed. It's not allowed.
Can you go back to TNC? TNCS?
TNCS.
Two different. Only difference in the house.
They call it multiple protective multiple of PME.
You need from the income source, they're using the same paper for neutral. In the individual house, the earning they look to the neutral.
Why still go back to the GP? Which one? This one?
You go back to Gen Z. They see the particle to the consumer side.
So this one?
Let's say 9 PE, you link to the both consumer side already, the third line and the second line. You go to GNCS, you relink, then why you need to look back to the cellular paper thing?
This one here.
Why? I see no people relink.
They are recommended. There is a multiple earning for the conductor. So ensure that when the conductor becomes open circuit for any reason, the exposed conductive wire remain connected to earth. Meaning that is multiple path. If let's say one end is broken, you still have another end. It's I would say maybe our LRT RLC system, right, when you connect. So they have a redundancy.
From the diagram, they connect the box.
This one?
In that, the socket is a thing, three plug, one is a two plug. Then you touch the.
This one? This one?
This one? No. The difference of TNC and TNC is a different that one. That extra line.
Then this is a looping socket.
Yeah, does it mean that the socket there is a 3-point socket? Whereby I don't know.
No, what did I mention? That some country only have looping, they don't have neutral.
Like your water kettle is a metal part. If there's a leak, you touch it, you get stuck. There's two wires. The two wires are protected, is it?
Okay, when you are using your equipment on you, it already become three phase, sorry, single phase already.
No, off or not off?
They are off.
Yeah. But if the two plug back on earth, live and
neutral. The neutral is the earth. Is it the neutral and is connect?
Is connected. Oh, the two is earth.
Yeah. So I would say this is grounding system. They do not have another dedicated earth.
But if our life neutral earth, then the neutral and earth.
So that is a dedicated path for earth.
Oh.
This MES system I think is used in Australia. The other countries are higher. But you won't find it easy. Okay. IT system. We will see this in Malaysia. So IT system is used normally in hospital or sometimes even data center. The benefit of IT system is they won't trip even if there is a fault. Because you can't afford to have the circuit tripping when you are having the life support system, okay, depending on electricity, your operating theater operating on electricity. So when there is a, they use other means, they use isolation transformer to isolate the fault. So they don't want the system to trip. You don't want the entire hospital to trip, right? Even data center. So if let's say, hey, why my touch and go cannot use, why my main bank cannot use, the data center trip really down already and half is up. So they don't want the data center to trip. So sometimes you see, I use IT system. Okay. So this is the one I mentioned just now. It's a fun question. When you have a leakage in the cable, so the jacket is clearly is injured already. But I guess this one is not from solution four. Maybe this one is a loose component, like to bite things. So for this one, you have to use a conduit or even the armor cable. When you have some armor, better iron armor to protect. Okay, for the regulation of ES7671, say you must have RCD for protection, tripping, in case of any fault. And then they will say the RCD shall not be more than 30% of the rated residual operating current. So for the RCD, they have a rating. The rating cannot be too high. So there is a good thing and bad thing. Okay. If the rating is very high, meaning it's not sensitive, it will take longer time to trip, and then you are exposed more to the fault region. But if it's too low, then skip leakage after trip. Then you have user tripping. Then you watch TV, watch the drama until the exciting part suddenly trip. You don't want that much. Okay. So the Malaysian standard 1979, based on the latest one, say RCD for single phase shall have a residual current not exceeding 180 amp. So go back home, open your TV, check your RCD rating. What is the rating? So sometimes the contractor may give you 300 amp. Maybe that is the previous, maybe before 2015. Okay, now I'm going to demonstrate with a simple. You have your socket. Don't try this at home. Okay, connect to live and neutral. Turn on, okay? Now suppose you take so this one proves that it's powered. Now suppose you take one of it and connect to earth. So this is phase to earth 4. So once it's turned on, then it will short.
dependent on?
Not sure, you will trip. Sound, it look very troubled.
The general
practical the practice in Malaysia, normally they will only pull one cable out, and then they will have a chamber, and then maybe three rod, two rod, maybe 4.5 meter. Generally, maybe. And then this cable size also, later we talk about that. Sometimes they use a very small cable only. Very small cable. And then this one, if you want to get less than 100 ohm, less than 10 ohm, it's very difficult. So what they do is, at the meter, your house meter, TNB meter, so this TNB incoming, then the TNB incoming, they have a shielding. Okay, they have a shielding. So they will connect this shielding to the TNB meter, because TNB meter is connected to here also, underground. Can we connect to the TNB incoming shielding? Because sometimes you have rocky soil, and the house or any building, we have a foundation made of rebar. So can we connect this?
This depth and to a depth of not greater than 5% just spacing apart.
So meaning if this is 1 meter, the depth we set at 0.055 is 50 mm. That will be 50 mm. So let's say the distance here is 10 meter. It's 10 meter. Then not greater than 5%, 5% will be 500 mm. Okay, 0.5 meter. But what if I want to drill until 0.5 meter? I still maintain at, let's say, 100 mm. What happened? Then, will. What happened, Christine?
The advice.
What is it? Okay, from our experience, because here they say it's... greater than 5%. So meaning maximum is 5%. You can have less than that. From our experience, if we do that, normally I think 99% of the time we just do the same that we never follow up to 5%. Then even if they drill at the maximum is 5%, they still get the same result. That's from our experience. The result is not much different. Yeah.
Oh,
never tried.
Oh, good question.
We just tried yesterday.
Uh-huh.
More or less. Because it's an empty space. Not have any buildings or any contactors. So more or less.
But you don't need to go up.
But it's some case that it's too shallow. If you drive the road too shallow, you can't get any bike. So we would have a bit too greater than 5%. I do have questions. Just now you mentioned the separation distance is 1 meter interval, every interval 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And just now you mentioned 10 meters. So is there any standards that mention can exceed 8 meters or 10 meters, or what is the maximum length?
That is later. I'll mention in my slide later.
Isn't it a comparison for the size of the device? I think it's
But do I look at the solid evidence as the Dutchship? They want to just, yeah. But they're selling their spare part to the cable lines only. So we assume that they provide this cable line, then they the machine
but
should.
In their user manual, they don't mention about the separation as well.
They don't mention. They only mention one cable.
One.
But they're selling longer cables, so we assume they do longer.
We cannot afford to go one until 1 meter, then 100 points. So we do like this, 1, then 1.5, 2, 3, 4.5, 6, 9, 13.5, then 18, 27, 35, finally 40. So 40 times 3 is total 120 meters. So this is the test that we need for this side. And this site has to be witnessed by the TNB personnel. This is the comment from TNB. And to make an appointment with TNB, normally we need 1 week in advance. So the officer has to be there, witness our test.
Can?
Are you
inside
meeting?
Huh? Are you inside meeting?
So how?
Meeting.
Huh?
Meeting.
Okay,